Thanks for coming. Just so as you know, all of your hard-earned greasy greenbacks are going to support the Fund for the Feminist Majority. So they're going to be fighting to keep abortion legal. And they're going to be fighting to get more women into the administration. And go out and register to vote. Let's get that sack of lion shit push out of the office. Here's Nirvana.
Keep your fucking laws off my sister's body.
Jesus, don't want me for a Sunday. Sunday's out that day like me. Don't expect me to cry for all these hurts.
Jesus, don't want me to fall. to the show to help keep abortion legal. And one of the reasons why the abortion issue is just the tip of the iceberg, it's a big issue, is because it seems like the government of the United States is into control. They want to control abortion, they want to control marijuana laws, they want to control your privacy, and it is wrong. You have all these yellow ribbon, flag waving, TV watching idiots saying America is number one, but listen to this. In education, America is number 16, 17, we're way down the ladder, right? So what they're saying is more control and less education. And that's a recipe for a disaster. Because the less there are free-thinking, informed people, the more they can impose their greedy, materialistic, back-scratching favor-type corrupt government practices to screw up the whole planet, not this country. And that's why you have to stand up for this issue. And it doesn't matter, if you think abortion is wrong, don't have one. Because, you know, we're not going to come into your church and say, you know, do this or that. That's not right. You know, whatever you believe. And it's a woman's issue too, because it's a woman's body. So I'm saying be educated. And think about the issue. And be educated in general, because that's what the United States needs. And smash your TV set, because that's the opiate.
a show tomorrow night at Jabberjaw. The Melvins are playing with Wool and Spoon, and you guys should go. It's at 9:30, and it should prove to be the best show you'll ever see in your life.
Take a ride.
jumping around up here, right? And this whole stage is like black rubber, and I'm playing barefooted, and the lights are cooking that rubber. I mean, my tootsies are baking. Oh, is that doctor reputable?
Mom and Dad went to a show. Dropped me off at Grandpa Joe's. Kicked and screamed, so please don't go. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
song's called Dennis Simon.
In the sun, she should have been the sun.
Thank you.
Songs for William Rehnquist. Shows, but tonight's a special event. Remember, this is everybody paid money in here to help keep abortion legal. Like what I was talking about earlier, it's the tip of the iceberg. But remember, it was last November, there was a coup in Russia, right? And all these capitalist suckers were saying, hey, it's the triumph of capitalism over communism. And to a little degree, that's true. But what it was about, it was about human spirit against totalitarianism and Stalinism, and people made a difference. So don't get whitewashed about this communism's a failure thing. You know, that's debatable, but that was a police state, and the United States is getting that way. So we gotta fight back while we still have a chance. Yeah. You guys are totally great. Remember, stay educated. And the revolution wasn't last November, but a few months ago, people power. Show the man.
Hey, kiddies, don't go. Nirvana posters, $10, signed in the lobby. Buy now.
You're all too kind. I feel like Jello Biafra up here. But he has a lot to say, too, so, you know, he's probably more qualified than I am, but, you know, just don't read USA Today or Time or Newsweek or all that propaganda rags, and you might, like, steer clear of all the distortion. What is that? It was a middle finger than peace, so what, translate that.
Nirvana fucking rip!
No, this person has something to say. Give him a chip.
Fucking don't ignore the papers, man. Just read them, but fucking have your own opinion, you know, and fucking keep playing the tunes, dude.
I don't know. You know, I'm not responsible for bombing 150,000 people in Iraq in January. It's the truth. Break my heart like everybody with a yellow ribbon did.
Yeah.
call me Joe Biafra, or call me Lenny Bruce, or call me whoever edits a National Review, but all I gotta say is this. Come on, people now, smile on your brother. Everybody get together, try to love one another right now.
See you Sunday.